Engineering construction of high-efficiency water-saving irrigation system. Efficient water-saving irrigation is the integrated application of high-tech, high-labor productivity, high-social, economic and ecological benefits to achieve good agricultural production results with a small amount of irrigation water. Its manifestation is pressure irrigation, including micro-irrigation, sprinkler irrigation and pipe irrigation. High-efficiency water-saving irrigation is a system engineering. Now Anu Irrigation explains the main link of water-saving system facilities construction and construction of high-efficiency water-saving irrigation. The planning of water-saving irrigation projects should collect basic information on water sources, meteorology, topography, soil and crops. The construction procedures of high-efficiency water-saving irrigation project include pre-construction preparation, measuring and setting out, pipe trench excavation, pipeline installation, system water test, trench backfilling and so on. Pre-construction preparation. Before construction, technical preparation, material preparation, labor organization preparation and construction site preparation should be done. Relevant personnel should be organized to survey the construction site and check the pipeline network and facilities against drawings. After the site investigation, construction personnel and materials are organized to enter the site. Measuring and setting out. The measuring should be carried out under the leadership of the chief engineer of the project. The construction personnel should locate the starting point, end point and middle corner points of the main line of the irrigation system network with wooden piles. The spacing of wooden piles is not more than 50 meters, which can be increased appropriately according to the topography and conditions. Pipe trench excavation. Pipe trench excavation should be carried out in accordance with the axis and design height of construction layout. Generally, the width of excavation should be 30 to 40 cm, the depth of pipe trench should not be less than 70 cm, and the depth below the driveway should not be less than 100 cm. The bottom of pipe trench should be neatened and leveled, and the excavated soil should be stacked on one side of pipe trench for easy construction. Pipeline installation. Before pipeline connection, the pipe fittings should be checked according to the design, and the appearance quality should be checked. Only when the pipe fittings meet the requirements of international regulations can they be used. The connection of tubing and fittings is usually made by hot melt connection. It is strictly prohibited to heat the open flame. When connecting pipes, it is better to use the pipe fittings produced by the same manufacturer. After connecting the pipes, the appearance of the joints should be checked in time and the unqualified quality must be reworked. We will explain the installation of Anu Irrigation DN20 200mm P pipe by hot melting. Connecting installation of pipe and pipe. Firstly, wipe the pipe joints with clean cotton cloth. Secondly, place the two pipes on the hot melt fixture at the same time. The fixture can change the clamp according to the diameter of the pipe to be installed, and then support the pipe with a special bracket to align the same level. Thirdly, milling the end of the pipe with a special pipe cutting tool. The section surface should be smooth and hairless, and it should be perpendicular to the pipe axis to ensure that the contact surface of the two pipe ends can be fully matched. Fourthly, the flat plate heat vessel should be heated in the range of 220 plus minus 5 degrees Celsius, and the hot melt connection can be carried out only after the indicator lamp is shown to be in the state of heat preservation. Fifthly, place the heat vessel between the ends of the two pipes. Operate the two ends of the welder and to heat with the heat vessel at the same time, pressurize it to 2 MPa. Heating is completed when there is about 5 mm flanging at the pipe joint. Finally, pull out the plate heat vessel, operate the pressure device to fully butt the melted ends of the two pipes and lock the pressure device to prevent rebound. Notes: do not move or exert any external force on the connector during the holding cooling period. After 10 to 15 minutes of natural cooling, the operation will be completed. Water cooling is strictly prohibited. The test length of pipeline pressuring cannot exceed 1,000 meters. Connecting installation of pipe and pipe fittings. Firstly, clean cotton cloth is used to wipe the pipe and fittings joints. Secondly, the socket heater is heated to 220 plus or minus 5 degrees Celsius until the indicator lamp is shown as red light. It can be hot melt joints. Thirdly, the socket hot melt tool is used to heat the inner surface and the outer surface of the pipe. After heating, the pipe and the pipe are quickly separated from the heating tool. The pipe is evenly inserted into the socket of the fittings to form a uniform convex circle at the end of the socket. Fourthly, after natural cooling for about 10 to 15 minutes, the operation is completed. Water cooling is strictly forbidden, twisting is forbidden during the cooling process. And the pipe can be sealed and put into use only after pressure test and acceptance is qualified. Capillary installation. Capillary is a pipe connected with branch pipe through offtake or offtake valve. The capillary of micro irrigation system usually adopts PE pipe of 16 or 20. When installing capillaries, they are usually installed on the surface of the ground. Each row of fruit trees is laid with one capillary, which does not need to be buried. Installation method: first, according to the irrigation position, perforate the branch pipe with the same type of capillary puncher. Second, insert the matching offtake or offtake valve into the branch pipe hole, feeling smooth and without clearance. Third, plug the tail end of the capillary pipe after the water test, so as not to block the emitter with dirt in the pipe. Installation of irrigator. Irrigator is the key component of micro irrigation system. It irrigates water with certain pressure in capillary to the soil near the root of crop to meet the needs of crop growth for water and fertilizer. Different irrigators can be selected according to different geographical conditions and crops. Irrigator can be divided into dripper, micro sprinkler, drip tape, and dripline. 1. Installation of dripper. The dripper is generally installed on the capillary, and the installation method is as follows. First, the dripper is drilled on the capillary with a special puncher, and second, the dripper is inserted into the hole. Generally, adult fruit trees need to be installed with 3 to 4 drippers spacing 30 to 50 cm and flow rate ranging from 2.75 to 3.2 liters per hour. 2. Installation of micro sprinkler. Micro sprinkler is usually mounted on capillaries. Installation method: first, a special puncher is used to punch holes in the capillary. Then the connecting kit on the micro sprinkler is inserted into the hole. The flow rate of the micro sprinkler varies from 10 to 200 liters per hour. Generally, a micro sprinkler is installed on a fruit tree. 3. Installation of drip tape and dripline. The drip tape and dripline are the irrigator which integrates the dripper and the capillary tube. It is directly connected with the branch pipe through the offtake or offtake valve. Installation method: first, punch on the branch pipe accordioning to drip tape and dripline size. Second, insert offtake or offtake valve into branch pipe hole. Third, release locking nut on offtake or offtake valve. Fourth, insert drip tape and dripline into offtake or offtake valve. Last, tighten locking nut on offtake or offtake valve. Installation of fertilizer applicator. The fertilizer applicator is the equipment that injects the soluble fertilizer solution into the irrigation system. At present, the Venturi fertilizer applicator is usually used to fertilize. The installation method is as follows. First, insert the plastic hose into the socket under the Venturi fertilizer applicator. Second, when the Venturi fertilizer applicator is connected between the filter and the water source to fertilize, first put the plastic fertilizer pipe into the stirred fertilizer bucket. And then open the two gate valves above the Venturi fertilizer applicator. in order to ensure the normal operation of the irrigation system. Annual irrigation suggests to follow these 2 points. Firstly, the fertilizer injection must be placed between the water source and the filter. The fertilizer first passes through the filter and then enters the irrigation pipeline, so that the undissolved fertilizer is removed so as not to clog the pipeline and the irrigator. Secondly, in order to avoid the blockage of pipes and drippers caused by fertilizer deposition, clean water should be irrigated for about 10 minutes before fertilizing. And then the pipes and drippers should be cleaned with clean water for 10 minutes after fertilization. Filter installation. The filters are usually installed at the head of the irrigation system. The ground should be hardened before installation and placed smoothly. The encrypted gasket is needed for the contact of the flange. A pressure gauge is installed at the inlet and outlet of the filter respectively. When the pressure difference between the two pressure gauges exceeds 0.02 mPa, the filter screen needs to be cleaned. The cleaning methods of the filter screen are as follows. First, shut down the valve and stop the water. Second, rotate handle to remove the filter cover. Third, remove the filter screen. Fourth, clean the filter screen. And fifth, check the condition of seal ring and gasket. Sixth, ray installation and water pressure test. Water pressure test. Last, check whether leakage occurs and observe whether the pressure gauge reading is normal. After installation, pressure test should be done to ensure no leakage occur. Annual irrigation suggests, first, when winter comes, water in the filter should be discharged to prevent rust. Second, collision and throwing should be avoided in handling and transportation. And rust-proof treatment should be carried out regularly on the outside of the filter. Systematic water test. After all the pipeline network systems are installed, water test should be carried out to observe whether the effluent of the system meets the design requirements. If it fails to meet the design requirements, the layout of the pipeline network should be adjusted. Pipe trench backfilling. After the water test is completed, the trench should be backfilled and the bottom of the pipe should be padded first. At the same time, no debris, bricks, garbage and other debris should be contained in the backfill soil within 0.5 meters on both sides of the pipeline and the top of the pipeline. Backfilling work needs to be completed symmetrically to ensure uniform pressure.